On the heels of St. Lucia's 44th independence anniversary, the country is said to be at a crossroads, and the direction taken will either catapult the island to future success or doom generations to subpar socioeconomic conditions. Sir Hilary Beckles, the Vice Chancellor of the University of the West Indies, made the observation as he delivered the Independence Anniversary Lecture. Tracing the development of St. Lucia through the green gold era, Sir Hilary told the audience that while the banana industry brought great prosperity to farmers and the local economy, it came at a cost. He noted that many farmers used their children as labor rather than sending them to school, consequently creating an illiterate society through the years. Contrasting the Barbados experience post-sugarcane, Sir Hilary indicated that a deliberate decision was taken to redirect that island's development.
The Barbadians did not replace sugar with another agricultural product. They didn't move from sugar to other agricultural options. They moved out of agriculture completely and promoted the services economy, tourism, finance, banking. And they already had a human resource stock of literate people who could give it the early development.
Sir Hilary credited the compulsory public-funded education policy that allowed for a modern economy to take shape in Barbados. He also credits St. Lucia's Sir Arthur Lewis for guiding Barbados through the path that made it an economic leader in the region today. Sir Hilary believes that the time has come for St. Lucia to make a determination on its own future.
The green gold has come and gone. And what we have is this beautiful, magnificent island that is a phenomenal asset. I am always struck by the beauty of the ecosystem. Beauty of this island is your gold. That is your new gold. That's your new gold. How can this beauty be monetized to become the future bonanza of St. Lucia? The environment, the ecosystem is green gold.
St. Lucia must have an education revolution, Sir Hilary says, in order to create a thriving economy, a revolution that would afford nationals with access to higher education and training. For the DBS News World, Lisa Joseph reporting.